students, today we are going to learn how to draw the ansa cervicalis. This is a very simple thing. Ansa cervicalis is a nerve chain which is present in the anterior wall of the carotid sheath. Okay, how it is formed? It all formed from the cervical nerves are there, no? Ventral rami of C1, C2, C3 cervical nerves. So C3, C4. I have drawn, okay, C1, C2, C3 I have drawn. Now what happens here, you will be having your hypoglossal nerve goes into the tongue, and here that C1 fibers, it comes and joins with the hypoglossal and comes down as superior root of ansa cervicalis, and then C2, C3, these two fibers, they join together and forms the inferior root. So the superior root and the inferior root, they join together and forms the loop of ansa cervicalis. This is how the ansa cervicalis is being formed. So this is inferior root and this is your superior root. Now what happens, the fibers which communicates here, they come out and they supply these two muscles, important muscles, thyroid and geniohyoid. So the C1 fibers goes via the hypoglossi and supplies these two muscles, thyroid and geniohyoid. The C1 fibers, they come along the hypoglossi and descends down. This is called superior root. This superior root supplies superior belly of omohyoid. And then this loop, ansa, this is called ansa. This supplies three important muscles. They are called as inferior belly of omohyoid and sternothyroid and sternohyoid. Okay, these three. So the MCQ is ventral rami or dorsal rami. So you should answer as ventral rami of C1, C2 and C3. And then the one which goes here, communicates with, that is hypoglossal nerve. That alone supplies the thyroid and geniohyoid, MCQ. And then superior root alone supplies superior belly of omohyoid, and the inferior root supplies all the three muscles. And the next question, the superior root lies on the common carotid artery and the inferior root lies lateral to the internal jugular vein, and it lies above anterior surface of the carotid sheath. So that's all about the ansa cervicalis.